Since it was introduced, the Volkswagen Jetta GLI has lived in the shadow of its sibling, the Volkswagen Golf GTI. It always made a little less power, didn't look as good, and so on. But now Volkswagen's trying harder to make the GLI on equal footing with the GTI, and at the same time own the sporty compact sedan segment. 2019 brought an all-new generation of the Jetta GLI, so not much has changed for 2020. In fact, nothing really has changed for 2020. So up here at the front, we've got the updated grille from 2019 with this red strip cutting across the middle and GLI badging up above that. Standard LED headlights and LED daytime running lights look really sharp. Down here, we don't have fog lights. Instead, we have some fake venting with some black trim on the outside. This paint color is called Pure Gray. It looks fantastic, and it's $295 extra. In my opinion, it is the color to get for this car. As we go to the side, we've got these 18-inch alloy wheels with black accents in the middle. I think they look great. They've got a motion to the design, wrapped in Hankook summer performance tires. Standing out from this GLI badge is this sharp groove character line that runs towards the back of the car, and then we've got an accent line down here. Here at the back, we've got a lip spoiler. This one is painted gray to match the body. In other colors, it would be painted black. LED tail lights, and then down here, a black diffuser with dual chrome exhaust ports. Looks very upscale. All right, so the big news for 2019, and really the crux of the GLI now being on equal footing with the GTI, is the power. Now it makes the same power as the GTI. So 2.0-liter turbocharged four-cylinder now makes 228 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque. That is routed through your choice of a 6-speed manual or 7-speed dual clutch automatic gearbox to the front wheels via a mechanical limited slip differential. 0 to 60 is 6.2 seconds, top speed 155 miles per hour, and your fuel economy is 25 city, 32 highway, and 28 combined. Now, as we climb inside the Jetta GLI, let's keep one thing in mind. This is the Autobahn version, so it has a whole bunch of extra goodies for $4,500 that you don't get on the standard car. What you do get standard is dual zone climate control, heated front seats, and this leather wrapped steering wheel with a flat bottom taken right out of the GTI. It's a great steering wheel. And you get a 6.5-inch infotainment with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Upgrades, part of the GLI package, is this large standard sunroof. They call it a panoramic sunroof. Not really. It's just a very large standard sunroof. The rear passengers don't really benefit in terms of panoramic visibility. You're upgraded to an 8-inch infotainment, and that's complemented by a fully digital instrument cluster. And these leather seats are not only heated, but they are ventilated. This driver's seat is power operated with Autobahn trim, wireless smartphone charging pad here, remote keyless entry, and remote start. And not only do you get one USB port in the Autobahn, you get two. So you got one here and one in the center cubby. I did forget to mention that as standard, you have blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic alert and automatic emergency braking. Now, one real test for me is if I can fit behind my own driving position in this sport compact sedan. And indeed I can. It's 6 feet tall. I've got knee room. I've got head room. Not a lot of it, but I've got a place where I can fit my head. One thing I would like is a little more room in the footwells, so my feet are kind of squished under here. I wish they had a little more breathing room so I could stretch out my legs a little bit. I also am not a huge fan of the fact that there is no rear air vent and no USB. The USB is in here in the center console, not a huge deal, but no air vents and some cheapy plastic in that place. In fact, this whole door panel is pretty cheap plastic here. Scratchy and doesn't give you much to look at. But I do like the amount of space, and I think in the Honda Civic Si sedan that this is competing against, I have much more room in here. All right, so the Jetta. First, how is it as a sedan? Well, with the Autobahn treatments, aka these leather seats and the upgrades to the digital cluster and the infotainment, feels pretty high quality. Certainly, there are some trim pieces that are gonna bring it back down to economy level, but for the most part, the things you're gonna interact with on a daily basis, this feels pretty good for the price. And the ride quality is quite good, especially because on this Autobahn, we have adaptive suspension. So when I go into the various drive modes, I'm gonna get a different suspension tuning. So here in comfort or normal mode, it soaks up road bumps pretty well. Go over a set here. Certainly not punishing as we're driving along, and that's where you're gonna want out of a daily driver. Visibility is also pretty good, even though this does have blind spot monitoring. I don't think that I would need to rely on that like I would in some other cars. All right, so average sedan, daily driver, checks the boxes. But this is not just your average sedan, it's a sports sedan. So I need to drive it more aggressively. To do that, I'm gonna switch over the drive mode to sport, which adds heft to the steering and improves throttle response and shift timing. And then I'm gonna get on it here with a set of corners. So it makes a much better noise as you get upper part of the rev range in this sport mode. And the steering feedback is so much better. And the suspension really keeps this car hunkered and flat in corners. So yes, the driving experience is notably better than GLIs of previous iteration. It feels much more like a GTI now. And that's what you want out of a car at this price and with this orientation in the market. See how the braking feels. Good, strong brakes. Definitely scrub speed easily. And if I wanted to, I could shift this in manual mode, pull the gear selector over to the right and use these paddles. Pretty responsive. Good turn in. Oh, that's fun. That is fun. Not the absolute fastest dual clutch out there, but it works. It works just fine. I still would prefer a manual transmission, and because it's offered, I'm absolutely gonna take that for a vehicle like this where you can have fun every day and it's not, you know, 400, 500 horsepower, so you won't be getting yourself into too much trouble, but having that controllability as a driver, at least while we still have manual options, is how I would go. But it's not a bad dual clutch. So standalone, the GLI is impressive as both a standard sedan and, of course, as a sports sedan. But how does it stack up with competitors? Well, when you're talking about compact sports sedans in the economical side of the segment, you have to consider the Honda Civic Si, of course, and now the Hyundai Elantra Sport. Now, both the Civic Si and the Elantra Sport make less power than this, right around the 201 for the Elantra Sport and 205 horsepower mark for the Si. They also start cheaper. So the Elantra Sport is just under 25,000, the Civic Si is just over 26,000, and the GLI starts at 27,165. As tested, however, with the dual clutch that adds $800 to that, and with the Autobahn package, this is 31,960, so just under 32,000. So a significant amount more than those rivals, where the rivals, you can't really bump up those price tags very much, but that also means you can't bump up the equipment. I really think as a more mature vehicle that's gonna grow with you for many years, the GLI is it. This has the performance you want, certainly more so than both of those vehicles I mentioned, and it has the more mature look to it, and the cabin has the space. Really, I think those other cars are more temporary purchases, and this one is really going to last you through a couple stages of life. I think Volkswagen has done a lot of great things here with the new GLI. It feels much closer to the GTI than ever before. If you want to learn more about the Jetta GLI and its competitors, go ahead and click the link in the description below.